Erin here from Byte Camp. Welcome back to our 2D video game series in Godot. In our last episode, we created our very first Godot project, and now we're ready to get started on our Villager Dungeon Nightmare game. In this episode, I'm going to be introducing the concepts of nodes, node trees, and how to import assets into our game. So, without further ado, we're going to get started on adding our villager to our game. The first thing that we need to do is add a root node to our game. In the top left-hand corner here, we see Create Root Node 2D Scene. Let's click on that. And as you can see, now I have the 2D view, and I also have my first node. So if I double-click on this node, I can rename it. Our nodes are like building blocks. We're building our game from the very basics, and then we're adding parts of our game as we go. So, to add our villager, what we want to do is we want to add an object that can move to our game. First thing I'm going to do is press this plus sign here that says add child node. Make sure you have your world node selected. Press plus, and I'm going to search for something called kinematic body 2D. And what this means is it's going to be an object that moves throughout my game. It's not going to be stationary. So I'm going to double click on that. As you can see, we have this little triangle with an exclamation mark there. And that's because we haven't got an image to go with that kinematic body. So we need to add another block to our game or another node. So I'm going to click on plus and I'm going to search for something called a sprite. Now, our sprite is basically an image that goes on top of that moving object. So, in our case, the image that we want to add is our villager. So, the team at Byte Camp has made this really great villager image. You can create your own using Inkscape or Gravit. We have tutorials on both of those programs on our YouTube and Facebook channels. So, if you're not sure how to do this, definitely check those tutorials out. I'm going to use an SVG image file for my game. So I'm going to click and drag this file, which is my villager, to my file system on the bottom right here. Now I have my image and I have my node, but currently these are not connected. So what I'm going to do is select my sprite, and on the inspector panel we see this text that says texture. And I'm going to click and hold and drag my image into the spot where it says empty. And there's my villager. Now my villager is in my game. One more thing before I do anything is to make sure my image is locked to that kinematic body. So I'm just going to click this box at the top right beside the lock. It says make sure the object's children are not selectable. Now I can move my character wherever I would like. Okay, so to review what we did today, the first thing that we did was we added our root node to our game. So that was our 2D space, our world. Then on top of our world, we added a kinematic body, which is essentially an invisible moving object. On top of that invisible moving object, we added an image. So our villager image that we created in Inkscape or Gravit, whichever you choose. Next episode, we'll be adding a falling emerald to our game, so make sure that you stay tuned so you don't miss out on future content. Bye everyone!